Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick. This is like the third video I made tonight, and the Lord really prompted me hard to make this video tonight, something that the Lord showed me a day or two ago. As you guys know, back in November, the Lord had led me to make some anointing oil and put it in little vials and pray over it and have you and bring it on the videos with me and ask you guys to pray in agreement with me, you know, and by faith, you know, it's our point of contact, that oil. And then the text that I talked about was from James chapter 5, where it says, is there any sick among you? Let them call for the elders of the church, anointing them with oil in the name of the Lord, and the prayer of faith shall heal the sick. So we know it's the prayer of faith, brothers and sisters. The Bible says one can put 1,000 to flight, two can put 10,000 to flight. So it's multiplying. We as the body of Christ, and particularly people who are mature in the faith, elders in the faith, you know, we come together in agreement and pray over that oil, as we've done, and it's multiplying. You know, it's multiplying our prayers to bring healing to people, physical healing, mental healing, spiritual healing. And praise God, I've had dozens, I would say about 25% of the people that have asked for oil, who I sent oil to, have messaged me back with people being healed and all kinds of stuff. Many people put comments on there. So praise God for that, brothers and sisters, because the Lord led me to do that. I've known about anointing oil. I've used anointing oil to pray for people since I started the ministry. I don't always use anointing oil. Sometimes I do. As I mentioned before in videos, it's people's level of faith. Some people's level of faith is, just like I've said in many videos, the woman with the issue of blood. She said, if I can touch the hem of Jesus' garment, I'll be made whole. That was her point of contact. That was her faith. She touched his garment and she was healed. There are other people who say, who pray by themselves at home and say, I have faith. The Bible says, by your stripes, Lord Jesus, I am healed and I receive it. There's other people that say, hey, if I go to someone who has the gift of healing, there's several ministries in the United States that have the gift of healing. Some of them you probably never heard of. There's a guy down there in Florida. Is his name Billy Bright? I can never remember his name. In Florida, you know, he's an example. He was someone healed as a child of a brain cancer. And then he started his own healing ministry since that time. The Lord used him in healing. And, he's like in his 50s or 60s now. Anyway, people like that. So people have the gift of healing. People believe, hey, if this person with the gift of healing prays for me, I'll be healed. There are people who believe it's a point of contact, that they anointed themselves with the oil that I prayed over. You guys prayed in agreement with me. Brother Sid came to visit me. We prayed over the oil. Brother Sid, who does the website for the Church of the Firstborn, we prayed in agreement over that oil. And then our prayers and our faith is in that oil. People's faith, a point of contact that they use that oil, they'll be healed. So praise God for that, brothers and sisters. Had over 200 vials that I've sent out, as I said, and praise God, about 25% of people have contacted me back saying that the prayer request was answered of healing and different kind of things, casting out demons, all kinds of stuff. So praise God. But the Lord has showed me something new in the Bible that I've never noticed before. I've never seen this before, but God, you know, opened my eyes to it, and he compelled me to make a video about it. Even tonight, it's already 2 o'clock in the morning. I was already in the bed, and the Lord prompted me because we've been packing to go to the Philippines. As I made a video earlier tonight, we're going to go back to the Philippines and build a third orphanage. Praise God for that. God has made a way. We have the funds to buy the land and get started on the building. So praise God for that. And I know that God will provide the rest by faith. My point of contact is believe that God will provide all things. He's Jehovah Jireh, to do the work that he called me to do by his grace. Anyway, so this is the text that the Lord gave me. Mark chapter 6, starting at verse 7. And he, Jesus, called unto him the 12 and began to send them out forth by two and two. He sent them out two by two and gave them power over unclean spirits and commanded them that they should take nothing with their journey save a staff only, no scrip, no bread, no money in their purse, and be shod, that's with on your feet, with sandals, and not put on two coats. And he said to them, in whatever place you enter into that house, that there abideth till ye depart from that place. And whosoever shall not receive you, not hear you, when you depart thence, shake off the dust on your feet for a testimony against them. Verily I say unto you, it shall be more tolerable for Sodom and Gomorrah in that day of judgment than for that city. I just read through that part because I want to tell you that the Lord sent his disciples, the apostles, out before they became the apostles. They were his disciples at this time. He sent them out two by two with a commission, you know, to do this. And in Matthew, it talks about how he sent them, you know, to declare what he was declaring, and what John the Baptist declared, repent for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. That's what the Lord sent them out to talk about Jesus, him, that he is the Son of God. Listen to this. Verse 12, and they went out and preached that men should repent. That's what I was just saying. Verse 13, and they cast out many devils and anointed with oil many that were sick and healed them. Did you hear that? I have never noticed this in the text. The text from James chapter 5, I preached on it 100 times. That's the text. Because, you know, we have to have our faith in the Word of God. Our faith is in the Lord. But when you're talking about put it into practice, you have to stand on the Word of God. So I stand on the Word of God when I anoint someone with oil, what it says there in James chapter 5. Is there any sick among you? Let them call for the elders of the church. I am an elder in the church. Anointing them with oil in the name of the Lord, which I do. And in the prayer of faith, by faith, I'm coming in agreement by faith. The prayer of faith will heal the sick. I'm coming in agreement by faith. And the oil is a point of contact. Following that Bible verse. You can use the Bible verse where by his stripes we are healed. That's your faith. You know, by faith I believe I can touch the hem of Jesus' garment. Spiritually, I can touch the hem of his garment. As there's an old Southern Gospel Baptist song, you know, that they sing in the churches. It says, you know, he's still passing by. I believe the Lord is still passing by. Of course, he's here. He's everywhere. I can reach out and touch the hem of his garment and be healed, just like the one with the issue of blood. As I said, as your level of faith, according to your faith, let it be unto you, as the Lord told the Phoenician woman. Anyway, listen to this. Verse 13, and they, that's the apostles, the disciples, they cast out many devils and anointed with oil many that were sick and healed them. I have never read that before, and I never even knew that disciples were anointing people with oil. Praise God. You know, it's just those things, brothers and sisters. The Bible is really, you know, spiritually discerned, it says. And unless the Lord would open your eyes or quicken, that's what he does. He gives life. The King James Word is quicken. The Lord gives life to the text, and he just brings it, boom, right up in your face. And the Lord just gave me this text, boom, yesterday morning. And he's been on me about this text since yesterday morning to look at it, to make a video about it. And not only about the oil, now as I've read it to you, the other part, before that, the Lord has quickened that in my spirit too. He wanted me to get that message. And the message is, you know, basically what I needed to hear. When you go somewhere and people receive you, great. If they don't receive you, shake the dust off your feet and keep rolling. You know, and that's the message for anyone that's in the ministry, anybody that's preaching. You know, if the peace of God rests in that place that's on you, so be it. If they will not receive you and they do not receive the message, Jesus says he who receives you has received me. You know, and he who has received me has received my Father who is in heaven, Jesus said. You know, so when they don't receive preachers, when they don't receive his servants, they don't receive the Lord. That's what Jesus said in a different text. So in this text, he said, hey, shake the dust off your feet and keep on going. That's a whole nother message, brothers and sisters. But praise God, that message is for anyone that's trying to do God's will and walking and proclaiming a preacher who's proclaiming his word. And I know there's some of you guys that are watching this. You know, shake the dust off your feet and keep on going. I have some of them coming to mind right now who I know it's in my spirit. They know who they are. God bless you guys. Praise God. Praise God. We're going to be leaving out for the Philippines, brothers and sisters, as I mentioned in another video. I'll be flying from Dallas the first week of February. I will be going to Dallas. I'll be in Dallas by the 1st of February. Praise God. If you want to see me there in Dallas, please contact me. I know last time I was there, I think I saw like 16 different people in a two-day period that I met individually, and some of them as a group. So praise God for that. By the grace of God, I'll see you. To all my brothers and sisters who in Florida, I'm sorry the Lord has redirected me. And I was, you know, just trying to get something going on and boom until the Lord directed me. And also in Tennessee, as I said, I'm sorry. It seems as though the weather is going to be bad as I'm crossing over there the last few days of January through the Appalachian Mountains. So I will probably take the southern route since I'm driving that RV. I don't want to take it through the snow and through the mountains anyway. I'll be probably going around down the southern route through Atlanta over to Dallas-Fort Worth. God bless you guys. I ask you to pray for us as we first travel in mercy as we go to the Philippines. I'll be making videos along the way. I'll be making videos in North Carolina. I'll be going there for a few days to store my stuff. And then I'll be with my brother's house, and then I'll be going out there. So I'll be making videos. God bless you guys. I love you guys. Thank you guys. Thanks to all those who donated so we can buy the land for the orphanage. We got a great deal that came together, a great deal on our plane tickets, a huge discount. on the plane tickets. It all came together at the same time to go ahead and go now. Everything came together to start the orphanage, brothers and sisters, the third orphanage. So praise God for that. As you guys continue to pray, we want to expand the feedings we do. Feed 800 to 1,000 kids every week that's outside the orphanage, basically street kids. I'd like to double that this year. And the Lord spoke to me about doing 10 orphanages today. I know we're waiting on the rapture. I hope the rapture is tomorrow, but the Lord just spoke to me tonight. 10 orphanages. And that's what I'm believing for. I ask you to pray in agreement with me for that. We'll do 10 orphanages for the Lord. If you want the rapture to hurry up and happen, and that's what your focus is on, hey, keep praying that, well, let's get it done. God bless you guys. Let's get those 10 orphanages done. Praise God so we can get out of here.